Hi, Michael. My name's Johnny Fergan. I'm from Ootola Coaching. What I want to talk to you today about the massive confusion, the massive despair, and the fogged minds we have in these current situations we all find ourselves in. I don't have to tell you the news because you already know it, probably some of you better than me, some worse. But one thing I will tell you is, in this time, most of us are confused. You need to take control of your life, mentally and emotionally, and control your life by doing tasks. Because majority of people are going from one YouTube video to the next, to next, to next, to TV, to upstates, to telling their friends about how bad this is, she is, he is, whatever. But the point is this, the more negativity you expose yourself to, the more confused you become, the more despondent you become, and the more despondent you become, the more depressed you become, and it goes down a slippery slope. And then you give up, like I said, mentioned many times in my videos, you give up hope. And without hope as human beings, that's why people commit suicide, because they see there's no hope. You need to stop being fogged, confused, and make a list of the things you need to do at home, reading books or whatever. Because if you do not control your life and give some normality into your life, you're going to wake up late, watch porno, do all sorts of things I'm not going to go into now, but you already know what I'm talking about. In this channel, I'll tell you the truth. You want to hear it, fine. If not, we both know you're watching dogs and cats and thinking it's funny, when really it brings nothing to your life. Now, I'm not saying you shouldn't watch it at all, but try to concentrate. Try to focus. Try to bring normality and tasks into your life that will empower you when you get out of the situation. Whatever it may be, I'm not here to tell you what to do. But if you do not bring some tasks, positive things that you do, you're going to go from one update to the next and next, and sharing how many people are queuing in the shops, and how he came close to you, she didn't come close to you, why didn't she say hello, she was too far away, too close, or whatever. I'm not going into what you're doing. The point is this, you need to focus and take a concerted effort to control your mind. Like I mentioned earlier about the confusion in our society, about how your mind is the most important thing. And you need to take a concerted effort and concentrate. Even if you can't do 10 tasks that you want to do, do 5. You can't do 5, do 3. You can't do 3, do 2. You can't do 2, do 1. You can't do 1, at least start. Because the most important thing in life happens when you start things, you get momentum. And once you get your momentum, you change the way you think slowly. But you need to take an effort. The hardest time to move a wheel or a big ball is at the beginning. It's extremely heavy. You push it slowly, 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 and then it gets momentum. It's the same thing. If you've been going down a slippery slope with all the bad news you've been hearing the last couple of weeks or months or whatever, it's very, very hard to reverse this unless you make a concerted effort to stop listening to negative people, to stop listening to the BS media, to stop listening to and sharing all the BS on social media. And make a concerted effort for once in your life to change how you think, how you perceive your reality, like I mentioned in this. And start concentrating. Start taking action, even small actions. I mentioned in this channel not once or twice about many, many books. But the most important ones is, in order to change your mindset, is How to Stop Worrying, Start Living by Dale Carnegie, and The Power of Your Subconscious Mind by Murphy. Because it's going to explain to you how to get out of the situation mentally you have in your mind. So you can change and take focus. Stop procrastinating and being a little boy or little girl looking for money for solutions, when the solution to all problems in 95% is within us. Not once or twice people that were sick with many, many diseases, because they believe they're going to get better, they got better. Because the mind is extremely powerful. And if you do not activate it, you're going to be on lower frequency. And we all know where that has got you, or most of us, in the past. So today I would like to empower you, or at least suggest you, to stop procrastinating. Get your life in order, at least to some degree, as much as you can. Write tasks down. Don't do them all. But start doing them. Because once you do one task, it'll bring you to the second, and the third, and the fourth, and the fifth, etc., etc. I'm your friend. I love you from the bottom of my heart. I was years ago extremely depressed and suicidal man. But a great friend of mine gave me these books. And I read them not once or twice, probably 20 times, so I can change the way I think. And this is why I want to encourage you to get some normality in your life so you can get things done and empower you to be a winner and a person that's got accountability and responsibility and not the victim mindset that so many of us today have. And this is why I wrote my book, How to Be a Man, What Your Father Never Taught You. In my book, I talk about what is a man, how to be a man. And the few things that I wrote there is accountability and responsibility and letting go of the mistakes we've done in the past, because I am guilty of that too. But if you do not make mistakes and learn from them and move on, how are you going to improve? And this is why I'd like to tell you, my dear friends, or share with you, how to be a man, what your father never taught you, will change your life. Whether you want to buy it or not, that's your decision. But it's about time you stop being a victim, take accountability and responsibility for your life. Because at the end of the day, if you don't, you're going to feel more and more victimized and more and more victimized. And if you're a victim, no matter who you are, you're never going to be empowered and you'll never have the ability to change. Because the only way we can change is when we take accountability and responsibility. So please, stop being fault. Stop being confused. Start concentrating, slowly but surely. Do some meditation daily. Run exercise a little bit. Do some sport, any of it. That's your choice. Anything, my dear friends, is better than nothing. I'm your friend. I love you from the bottom of my heart. I tell the truth on this channel. Some people don't like me, and that's okay. It's their choice. Some people, they'd like me and email me. Thank you so much for being part of the real truth. Majority of people today don't want to hear the real truth. They prefer to be a victim because it's far easier to be a victim. You don't have to do anything to be a victim. All you do is copy and paste your victim. Poor people, poor, poor, poor. But at the end of the day, if you don't help yourself, you're not going to get anywhere. There's only so much or so long you can pretend to be a victim. And after that, people get sick of you. You know it and I know it, because we all know a few people that are victims. So today I ask you, please, try to stop being fogged. Try to stop being fogged by bringing some normality in your life. And start concentrating. If not on 10 tasks, 5. If not 5, 3. If not 3, 2. If not 2, 1. At least start. So you can get things done for your own sake. Be accountable and responsible. Stop being a victim like so many people know. Thank you very much. As always, you know what? I'm your friend, Johnny Fricker. Bye-bye.